Welcome to Miami. You're back to the place where it all started, huh?
With back the to the scene of the crime, Luis.
Thank you, Luis.
This is what I do. I'm an undercover narcotics agent. I sit with murderers and made men, and I lie. I lie my ass off.
Excellent movie, amazing performances. Everybody in the movie theater was like loving every second of the movie. You know, Leguizamo made us laugh. You guys put us in a situation where we're all like wondering what was coming up next. How do you guys feel when you sat down and watched the movie?
It's a little daunting because we remember shooting it and remember the sequences, and for us to see it for our first time, we're more critical, I think. It's like, they took that one. If you see it a second time, then I'm able to kind of wash it away and take it for what it is as a piece of entertainment. But it's a good story, so we're both proud to be a part of it.
It's probably a generalization, but I know for myself personally, I don't really enjoy too much watching my own work. But there are rare times when in watching something I'm participating in, where I get swept up in the story, and I can actually watch the film for what it is, and that happened with this. So. To me, that always indicates that this must be actually pretty good.
Yeah, sometimes you do. You see a right. movie that you're in and you forget you're in it.
Yeah,
it's like, that's right, I'm in this movie.
And of course,
that's me.
in this case, it wasn't hard because everyone knows how tremendously talented Brian is. He's one of those rare actors that has that combination of both decency and danger and this.
And extremely good looking.
And you know, extreme mm-hmm. good looks. Mm-hmm.
I think we've been doing this backwards. We've been following the drugs to get to the bad guys. What if we chase the money?
It's crazy to think how this is a real story, you know what I mean? That everything that we saw in this movie happened in real life. For you guys to portray a character that's actually a real person, is it harder than actually portray somebody who is like a fiction, something that's created, or what's the difference between both?
Yeah, that's a good question, Luis. It is. I think not every actor takes on that extra responsibility, but I think I welcome it. I want to get as close to the essence of that character as possible. If you're playing someone who is well known, there is already a look and a stature, perhaps even a way of speaking that you have to get close to. In this case, there wasn't that, but it behooves you to get as close to knowing that character as possible.
Welcome to A Life of Crime.
Let's do this.
Welcome to the United States.
These men launder all the money for the cartel.
I need a face-to-face with your boss.
It was an audition. You got the part.
So, Mr. Musella, what can you do for me?
John Leguizamo is hilarious in the movie. As much as there's so much tension in the movie, his parts are so funny. You know, even with one sentence, he made the whole audience laugh.
He's a terrific actor, a wonderful performer. But also his nature and his personality on the set lifts the entire crew. He's light in his feet. He's spontaneous. And it just creates for a better working condition. To have someone like that, but he is no less an actor than anyone else we've worked with. He really brings it. There are several scenes where we improvised when he was working on his car in the graveyard scene and things like that, where we just went off knowing our characters and you know we're right with each other and it's fun to play with. But he's great. And every good movie like The Infiltrator should have. A dose of lightness to it, you know, and some levity to it. So you can give the audience a little bit of a breather so they can laugh and have a good time and then get tense again.
We need to find new undercover identities.
Hey, look at this, Falcone.
Look at the dates.
Yeah.
Do the math. I'd be 77 years old.
That's about right, leathery and craggly.
I'm a friend of John's, but I'm also a fan. I've been a longtime fan of his. And Brian's so right on the nose with this that there's so much tension that gets ratcheted up from beginning to end of the film that you need to give the audience a moment to breathe and take it in and process. And John has a genius way of figuring out just where to put the joke, to puncture the tension just a little bit. He's remarkable in the film. I think the relationship that they develop on screen is, you know, it's a kind of twisted Batman and Robin scenario, but really works to serve the film well.
Do not do business under threat. Unfortunately, you are not in a position to dictate terms to Don Pablo.
This is a cop. One wrong move and we're dead.
In my business, when there is no loyalty, it never ends well.
Are you in danger from Pablo Escobar?
We have a chance
to take them all down.